George Corey, our manager, he was the first person to play the song, and Ashley had sent it to him. And we're suckers for Ashley Gourley. We've written a bunch of songs with Ashley, as well as recorded you know, some of his songs like Love Ain't. And we're just a sucker for the way he moves lyrics around melodies. And right away, I mean, you could just hear the melody in the song from the top and know, okay, this is a special one. And the spin, I mean, it's one of those songs lyrically you just wish you would have thought of. It's so easy, so simple as far as ideas go. It's just one of those ones you wish you would have written. And we know that that's always the first, you know, rule. Like, if you hear something that you wish you would have thought of, it's worth that second listen. And I think that from the get-go, we knew Break Up in a Bar was special. And we just started playing it in our live show, and we ended up putting it as the second song in the show. And it's funny to see the audience, because they want to know it so bad, and it's almost like everybody's like, I think I remember this song, and they're trying to sing along, and that's a good sign. I think that Break Up in a Bar is going to be a big one for us.
There was something about the demo that didn't sound like an Eli Young Band song, but it was such a great, well-written, just fun, clever hit, checked so many boxes, that I gravitated towards it immediately, and just knew if we could spend a little bit of time, get in the studio, and when we recorded it, it would sound like us. And so I think that was the one song that I was nervous about kind of fighting for on this batch of songs, because I just felt like we would fit into it once we had a chance. All the rest of the songs, since Mike was a part of writing and he had lived with so long, I had no concerns there. But on this song, I think we're all really, really happy the way it came out. But this one felt like it may have been a bit of a stretch until we got in there, like, okay, we can wrap ourselves around this.
I think there was a moment of everyone tiptoeing around whether or not we should go to bat for this song, or whether or not they should go to bat for this song. Because I had put so much time and so much energy into writing all these songs for the next project, and I think everybody was kind of, should we push harder? Should we not push harder? And I'm glad they did. I think this is going to be a big, special song. Even if it's not the next single, it's going to be a big song for us, for our catalog. You know, I think you can already tell people are latching onto it from when we play it live. So
we needed that kind of song. I mean, it's just that kind of country song. It's the kind of country that we all like, and it just, for that song to fall into our laps, it was like, okay, there's that song that we need, like, in our repertoire, and so, yeah, we're lucky to have it.